Hi. So it is time for another super big moment in our life of learning to program the computer. And in fact, this may very well be the biggest moment of all of the moments, and I'm sure I'll just say in the next video it's the biggest moment. But right now it really is. Because we're going to start talking about conditional statements. That may not sound like it's the most super biggest moment ever, but it really is. Let's understand why this is going to be such a huge leap forward that we're going to take. Perhaps you don't remember where we last left off. Where we last left off, we had this nice processing sketch. We were learning about variables. We declared a variable at the top. We initialized its value to zero. And then we manipulated the value of that variable by incrementing it every time through draw, which looped over and over again. And when we run this sketch, we have our circle, and it's going. There it is. It's going very, very slowly. So this is like awkward now. But eventually it's going to get to the end and it's going to leave and it's not going to come back. And that's sad. It's a sad moment for the circle, for us, the programmer, for processing, everything. But we will now get over this sad moment and we're going to add something new to our bag of tricks, our bag of tools. We're going to be able to say, If the circle reaches the end of that window, do something else. Change color, turn around, reset your position back to somewhere else. This is what we're going to do in this videotape, so we're just going to get started with this. So let's start, let's move over here, and let's think about what are the nuts and bolts of what we're doing. We are writing now a new kind of block of code. It is called a conditional statement. I will write this down. Conditional statement. And it is going to look like this. If, open parentheses, this is the squeaky pen. I don't know where the other one is. Can I pause for a second? Pause. Okay, got a new pen. If, open parentheses, close parentheses, open curly bracket, close curly bracket, some code. I guess all of these pens squeak to some extent, but hopefully it's not bothering you like it's bothering me. Okay, so enough about the pen. What do we have here? If, parentheses, something that's going to go in the middle here, open curly bracket, close curly bracket. So this looks familiar in some ways. This is a block of code. Just like we had setup and draw, setup has a beginning and an end with the curly brackets. Draw has a beginning and end with the curly brackets. But we are now having a block of code. What this block of code means is if whatever is in here is true, then execute this code. If not, don't execute this code. So this is a moment where we now have the ability to add some logic to our program that lets the program take a path. It could choose to execute some code, it could draw some stuff on the screen, or it could not draw some stuff on the screen. It could change the values of some variables, or it could not change the values of some variables. So if it's always doing this through draw, every time through draw, sometimes it'll execute things one way, sometimes it'll execute things a different way. This allows our program to have different behaviors at different moments in time. So this simple, simple structure is incredibly powerful and important. So what I want to do in this video is really just talk about, obviously there'll be a whole set of videos about conditional statements, we'll look at lots of scenarios, but what I want to focus on in this particular video is really just this question mark. What goes in there? And what goes in there is known as a Boolean expression. Now a Boolean expression is an expression that evaluates to only true or false. For example, I could say, my name is Francis, and that would be false. Or I could say, I am an extremely nervous person, and that would be true. You know, but the thing about it is, that's a little bit, I should point out, that's a little bit subjective. You know, we could, in English language, we might say things like, I'm feeling a little melancholy today, and that, you know, that could be sort of true, mostly true, but not exactly true because I'm only a little bit, I don't know what I'm saying here, but the point is, when the types of Boolean expressions we're going to write for a computer program are going to be distinctly true or false. Only one or the other, no gray area whatsoever. Now, there are many ways that we're going to see that we can create a Boolean expression, but the simplest way, what's going to be most useful for us right now to start with, is using something called a relational operator. So let's make a list of relational operators. What are relational operators? Here's one. Greater than. This pen really does squeak. Another one is less than. Greater than or equal. Less than or equal. I'm going to list a couple here more at the bottom that are a little bit goofy. Equals, with two equal signs, or not equals, exclamation equals. So one of the things about programming is sometimes syntax can be a little bit cryptic, right? If I want to ask if something is not, if I want to test if a value is not equal to another value, I need to know that the symbols for that are exclamation point equals, not equals. So we'll see examples of this as we go. I think for right now, let's just focus on just these two simple relational operators. This will get us going. So let's write some Boolean expressions. Here is a Boolean expression for you.
6 is greater than 5.
This is an expression that evaluates to true or false. Is this a true statement or is it a false statement? That is definitely,
most definitely true.
Here is another one. 717 is less than negative 10. Is that true or is that false? That's quite obviously false, right? There is no way for this expression to be something other than true or false.
Even if I say 7 is greater than 7,
is that true or false? That is false.
So we can see these are the types of Boolean expressions that we can write
with these relational operators. Is one value greater than another value? Is one value less than another value? Less than or equals, equals, not equals, etc. So these are Boolean expressions using relational operators. That must mean they go in between the parentheses up here, because this is where you put your Boolean expression. If 6 is greater than 5, execute that code. If this expression evaluates to true, execute this code. If this expression evaluates to false, skip and keep going, right? Don't evaluate that code. So now let's look at this and think to ourselves, does it make any sense at all in any universe to write that code? Think about that for a second. Well, I'm going to make the argument right now that this, while syntactically is correct, it's no logical value, right? Because 6 greater than 5 can never, ever be anything but true. So there's no point in having this conditional statement because we're always going to execute that code. The point of writing these Boolean expressions is not to use hard-coded numbers, but to use variables. Variables which have variable values. Sometimes the value of that variable might be greater than 5. Sometimes it might not be greater than 5. For example, what if I were to say if mouse x is greater than 5? So if the value of the mouse x, if the value of the mouse's x position is greater than 5, then execute that code. So only when I have my mouse over here, execute this code. If I don't have my mouse over there, execute some other code. Think about it, like if you need to program a rollover from scratch, right? You have this rectangle on the screen, and whenever the mouse is over that rectangle, you want it to light up and change color. That's how you're going to do it. If the mouse x is greater than here, and if it's less than here, and if mouse y is greater than here, and if it's less than here, it's within all these bounds, then draw a different color. This is where we're going with this type of stuff. Okay, so I think this kind of gives us the pieces, the beginning pieces of what the form of a conditional statement looks like, what a Boolean expression is, what some basic Boolean expressions are using relational operators. Let's just look at one tiny little example in code, and then we'll move on to the next video. Okay. So let's put aside our bouncing ball, the program that we're hoping to eventually turn into a bouncing ball, a sketch for a moment, and let's do something quite simple. So here we have a processing sketch that does nothing but draw a gray background, size and background and draw. Let's add some new code in here. Let's add this conditional statement. If mouse x is greater than, I don't know, pick a value. Anybody? There's nobody there. It's just me. It's very sad. 200. Then I'm going to say background. I pick a color, any color, green. Or red, that's red, I guess. I don't know. A little yellowish something, whatever. Here's another color. We're going to run this sketch. Look, gray background. Look, there's a line of code in there. Background, some other color, but we're not seeing that. It's not happening. Why? Because mouse x is currently not greater than 200. What is the value of mouse x? I don't know, maybe it's about 20. 30, there's an exciting moment that's about to happen, 50, 100, 150, ah, there it is, it's orange. Wow, that's a nice color, I like orange. So you can see that, so we can see pixel 200 is right about there, and we could be a little bit better about this, and we could do something like, say, stroke 255, draw a line at pixel 200, and so that I could at least see that, hey, whenever the mouse is on this side, it's gray, whenever the mouse is on this side, it's orange. So, you know, this is like quite possibly the most a very, 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 very simple beginning of conditionals. But I would venture to say for a moment that one of the amazing things about programming is all you really need is data, variables, and conditionals to be able to make different choices. We're going to look at lots of stuff, loops and functions and objects and all sorts of other fundamentals of computation, but I would suggest that even with just all that I've shown you so far, that you can have variables and that you can have a conditional statement, there's nothing you could not program right now. Nothing. Everything else is just going to be about helping make your code shorter, more organized, more efficient. I mean, obviously, you're really going to want to have a loop. Otherwise, you sometimes have thousands of lines of code. But really, it's a sort of important moment to realize that you now have all the tools to make anything you could imagine. So you should really start giving this a try. So if you're looking for a little exercise to try before you get to the next video, what I would suggest now is think about this program. Could you write a conditional statement that executes this task? If the circle reaches the right-hand edge of the window, reset its location back to the left-hand edge. Now, I stated that in a sort of very English language kind of way. I could state it more like code, more like pseudocode, more like code, and eventually write the code for it. But think about that. Where would you put that conditional statement? Can you get that to work? Very simple exercise, and we'll move on in the next video and do more with this stuff. Okay. But I want to say something profound at the end, but there is nothing profound other than I am staring into the abyss of an empty camera, and I bid you adieu. Because I am every once in a while saying something in French.